Music was my first love.
Southampton fans still savour FA Cup ties with Manchester United. The memories of 1976 lived on as they faced them in this season's competition. And all because that glorious day in May, Lawrie McMenemy's underdogs turned the tables on United.
Lawrie McMenemy savouring this occasion.
With 7 minutes to go, a little striker from Portsmouth of all places scored the most famous goal in Southampton's history.
The Cup was such a glorious occasion, and of course the goal was terrific, and 7 minutes from the longest 7 minutes in my life, I can tell you, and it was just wonderful when the final whistle went.
And the whistle has gone, and Lawrie McMenemy and Southampton take the Cup.
I don't think it sunk in. It sounds a bit soppy. I think I was pleased for the players because they ran towards me, a lot of them.
Meets the players now.
And the team returned to the city to an unprecedented welcome.
That trip round, I don't know how long it took, but it was fantastic. An open-top bus, and it crawled along. And, I mean, famous memories. One fella had told his pals, if they win that cup, I'll run round here naked. And, of course, there he was, totally naked, standing like that when the bus went by. The supporters are the people that matter. It's their club, and on the day it was their cup.
Manchester United have proved a common foe throughout our side's cup exploits. No Brighton fan will ever forget the moment the trophy slipped through their fingers in the 1983 final.
And Smith must score, and he hasn't scored, and Bailey has saved it.
The following year, as holders, United crashed out at Bournemouth. It was the springboard to a young manager's career.
It's got to be the greatest day in my life, and I'm sure the greatest day in the lives of all the players.
We went to a restaurant before the game, and the owner of the restaurant said to Ian Lee, our goalkeeper, who was a Southampton boy. He was a big lad. He loved his food, and he said, if you keep a clean sheet today, he said, you can come in this restaurant for the rest of your life and have free pizza. Fantastic. I thought, well, there's no chance of that happening anyway, you know, but... The unfortunate thing was I bought that restaurant a little while after that, and but when he came in with his three pizza, I said, sorry, I'm the new ownership, Nipper. No pizza here now.
Redknapp would finally get his hands on the cup in 2008, his Portsmouth side beating Cardiff at Wembley. 200,000 fans welcomed them home, and an excited Roger Johnson described the scene.
The noise is astonishing. The sight is amazing. And Portsmouth are expressing their joy.
To win an FA Cup was everybody's dream, you know, whether you're a player, manager or whatever. Walking out of Wembley with your team, it was something I'll never forget. It was just magnificent.
That's the magic of the Cup, that anybody can beat anybody on one day.
To give so much joy to everybody, it was incredible. See you.